Welcome back to 120 Minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield, and joining me are Nina and Louise Vrukasaw. Good to have you here.
Thanks. Hi.
Yeah, you have a brand new album out, and it's called Eight Arms to Hold You. But what I'd like to ask you first, let's talk a bit about how the whole thing happened with Seether originally, with Mini Fresh. I mean, the single, it blew up, and there's a lot of anticipation, obviously. There's a big bidding war, and then American Thighs was very successful. So how did you feel a lot of pressure in having to follow that up at that point, or did you just, you know, I wanted to ask you about that.
Well, I think we tried to diffuse the pressure of having to follow up a big single with our EP,
Blow It Out Your Ass.
Really just so that we wouldn't feel the pressure. We wanted to put out something without a big single, without a big video, just for our fans, and so that we had something to tide us over. And just to put something out, just to be a band, without all the hype and all of the craziness around it.
Yeah, I thought that was a good decision.
But also, we were so excited to go into the studio and record our second full-length record, because the first record was made such a long time ago. We spent so much time touring that by the time we were ready to make the second record, we were just ready. We kind of knew what we had up our sleeves. We were, like, ready to go. So it wasn't, we weren't nervous. We were really excited.
Yeah, I mean, there was definitely an air of confidence in every record you've done, I really felt.
That's nice to hear.
Well, thanks.
You know, there was. And Blow It Out Your Ass, Vrukasaw, was a good decision to come back and do that EP. Now, you did it with Steve Albini. As you said, you wanted to do something that was more stripped down and for your fans. Was using Albini as a producer part of that decision, too? Was it having him because you liked the things that he had done that had been raw?
Yeah, we really admire Steve and all of his work. And he's kind of a neighbor. He lives in our city. And his girlfriend and a good friend of ours were kind of conspiring to get us to work together. And it really didn't take much, because we were really dying to work with him. So it was easy, quick. He's a very pragmatic engineer/recorder. I don't think he likes to be called producer. And it was just the best thing we could
He's
do.
He's also very foul-mouthed.
And that's enjoyable in the studio.
It always is, yeah.
Kind of just christened the debutantes with a really gross joke right when we walked in the door. It was just like, let's just get this out of the way right now, okay?
Yeah, exactly. That sounds cool. Vrukasaw will be back to talk with us some more, but in the meantime, here they are with their first video. Here's Seether. Where they... There's like a Love and Spoonful sounding version of it.
Isn't that the coolest thing when bands do reprises on records? We forgot to do that.
Yeah, well, we have plenty more records, plenty more chances to do that.
But it's just cool. It's cool to, I don't know, reprises and referring to yourself and that kind of thing. We're into that.
Now, in Volcano Girls, in the song, you refer back to Seether, by the way, which and you do the Glass Onion thing from the Beatles, where, you know, you do the whole Clue situation. Well, you saw Seether before, too, right?
Yeah, thanks for showing that video in which I look like a Muppet baby. You have to show the Seether video. You know, we have a couple other videos where we look cute, but Seether video.
Yeah, you look excellent. Oh,
hey, that video was good to us.
No one saw it, but
that video got us on a tour bus.
Yeah,
got us out of the van and onto the tour bus. So,
thank you, Seether.
And thank you, MTV.
But the reason you did Glass Onion?
Oh, yeah, well, I love when bands refer to themselves. I love the whole self-referential thing, and also referring to other bands, because we're all music geeks. I mean, we're all music geeks, all of us. I can include you in that. Where, you know, you just, like, we love wearing our influences on our sleeves and talking about
and our feet. Killer Kiss Destroyer boots right now in arenas. I love those.
Getting ready for arena rock.
Yeah, because you're going to be opening for Bush. It's going to be
That's right.
Good time.
But, you know, you've got to, it's like, I don't know, I just think of being in a band as like being in a club or something, and it's fun to just, like, have little references to things. I mean, putting the Seether thing, the Glass Onion thing, was just a joke. I just thought it would be funny.
Yeah, I think it's great. Yeah.
Hey, I'm the Seether. Don't deny me that.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. I know you are, and always will be.
We'll be back with Vrukasaw in just a bit. In the meantime, here are the top 10 singles on alternative music this week.